just all the players is welcoming me like a little brother, and they're all just taking me up under their wing, just, you know, showing me the ropes.
I understand you guys had another round of mat drills this morning at 6 a.m. How's the work with Coach Mick going already?
Well, I love working with Coach Mick. You know, he's a great guy. He pushes the best out of me. He motivates me. And I can tell from what he's doing to me so far, you know, it's working, and I'm getting stronger and bigger and faster.
Have those workouts been like you expected, tougher, better?
Well, they're highly competitive, I would say that. But, you know, I went, like, they're tough, but, you know, they're not too tough because, you know, if you're mentally strong, you can get through anything.
You know, there's been a little uncertainty with Coach Combs leaving. Coach Gianna's been talked about with the Patriots. Has that been an interesting transition? How's that been for you?
Well, one, Coach Combs, he didn't leave, you know. He just did what's better for him and his family. And we respect Coach Combs as a man, as a father, as a coach. You know, we look at Coach Combs sort of like, you know, a father for ourselves. Because Coach Combs, he did what was best for him and his family. And that's what a real man does at the end of the day. And Coach Shannon isn't going anywhere. It's a brotherhood and wearing it together.
He isn't going anywhere? Is that what you said?
He's not going anywhere.
What have your early impressions been of Coach Grinch?
Coach Grinch, he's a fun guy, energetic guy, you know, who knows what he's talking about and just love football.
And physically, for yourself, what did you enter in at weight-wise, and where were you trying to be at by the end of spring?
Well, my body weight goal is 190. I came in at 190, so, you know, I'm at a good place, just maintaining, getting stronger.
When you know your position at this school, how high that expectation is, what's kind of the mindset you have to have, even this time of year? What are we, 8, 9 months from the season? Seven, I guess. Math's not great for me.
Well, just be a sponge. You know, we got older guys like Damon Arnett, Kendall Sheffield, guys like that who've been out there and played. So just being a sponge for them, like imitating everything they do, you know, whether it's drills. I'm taking like over 2,000 mental reps a day on everything they do, whether it's film or whether, you know, it's just out here and we get to work on our own. You know, I'm just taking mental reps and just asking questions so they can teach me.
And just to clarify, did you say Coach Chiano's not going anywhere?
He's not going anywhere. He's
okay.
Be right here.
So he told you guys that?
Yes, sir.
Good. Cool.
What do you have as expectations for yourself as a freshman? Obviously, you know, like you said, there's guys in front of you. What do you see yourself doing year one here?
I want to contribute to the team as best as I can. You know, whether it's special teams or whether it's even being out there on the field. You know, me personally, I want to be out there on the field making plays on defense. But, you know, if my role is special teams, I'm going to give it all I have.
Do you look at a guy like Jeffrey Okuda who came in and obviously was contributing more towards the end of the season, but made that special teams kind of position his own?
Yes, sir. I do. You know, like, Jeff came in, did his role, and, you know, it paid off for him at the end of the season.
What does it mean to be a defensive back at Ohio State?
Well, being a defensive back at Ohio State means everything to me. You know, because, one, we take pride in, you know, don't letting our man catch the ball. And a defensive back at Ohio State is held to high expectations. You know, we have to be first round. So, you know, it's just kind of big shoes to fill, but we will fulfill it.
What was it that sold you on coming here?
Well, it was the brotherhood. You know, that Penn State game was huge for me. You know, my cousin Sean Wade's here. You know, he told me that guys like Damon Arnett and Kendall Sheffield and people like that just, you know, come on, you know. You know, we got plenty of opportunity here, and, you know, we're going to develop you. And another thing that sold me about Ohio State was the Real Life Wednesdays, because that shows that Coach Meyer is just not in it for football. He's also in it to develop you into a better young man.
You see, Marshall.